Sri Devasena, we've interacted a few times, but to me, she lives by this statement where, you know, she shows you that there is a huge contribution of your personal value systems in the success that you achieve. She's aptly going to talk about this because she is the director for education for Government of Telangana. I couldn't have thought of anyone better than her. Shrikant Bulla, I don't have to speak about Shrikant. President Kalam talks about Shrikant. And I'd like Shrikant to talk about some of it himself and also about the experiences that he has had through the journey that is no less challenging in by any measure. Mahesh Bhagwatji, again, doesn't need any introduction. He is known as, what I hear, is the policeman of the people, where he believes that development of society goes hand in hand with law and enforcement. Responsible citizens with values can make a progressive society. Sanjeev Jain, Vice President of IBM, has lived values on a daily basis. He contributes to society, to betterment of people who are a little less privileged than him, and he does this over and above what he does as his profession and career. He contributes to society on an everyday basis. There are innumerable success stories of his contributions, of his mentorship, of his guidance to the society. So with that, Devasena, I'd like to go to you, and I'd like you to talk about what contributions values have made to your success, to your growth, and what they really mean to you personally, Devasena.
A very good evening to all the participants here. Two of the participants are my very esteemed seniors, Jayashanjan sir and Mahesh Bhagwat sir. And of course, pranams to Guruji. Lovely to see you, Guruji. I'm so happy. And of course, Pullela Gopichand garu, Sudarshan Acharya garu. I don't know if I'm here to learn as much as to, you know, share my experiences. I'm probably much too junior to all the persons here to be able to share something of great value. But Praveena, since you've asked me to share a few experiences, I'll start off with just one. I've always believed that we have kind of underestimated the power of doing the right thing. A lot of people think that if you do the right thing, you might get into trouble, or you might not have the power to face people who are actually doing the wrong things and who are more powerful than you. But the real power, I feel, lies in doing the right thing and believing in doing the right thing. And this, the first taste of this lesson I got in my first posting when I was posted as RDO Hyderabad. This was way back in 1997. So this was an incident when, as you know, the Hyderabad Secretariat, the old one, right now it's being demolished, but at that point of time it was a huge landmark. Excuse me if I'm a little too, talking a bit too much, but let me express things the way I would like to. Kindly put up with me.
Absolutely. We are very keen on listening from you. I mean, all of us are.
Okay. So what happened was, that time I was RDO and my collector was Mr. Bhavarlal, who served as the chief executive officer, chief electoral officer of Telangana state, a very, very right, upright person. So I was working under him. So he told me that my first task was to remove all the encroachments within the secretariat. This was right in the middle of the town, in the city, and there were more than about 600 families who had to be removed. So multiplied by, say, minimum of 5, there were 3,000 people who lived in encroachments within the secretariat premises. And the then chief minister was very particular that he wanted to have a helipad and new complexes, new office complexes. So it was a kind of a challenge for me to do it in the minimum possible time. So when I called for the file and had a look at it, it turned out that this issue had been pending for almost 60 years. 60 years. It started off as a small encroachment, and all the other employees of the secretariat began to, build their small rooms and then extend it as people get married. And then it became a complete, huge, big encroachment of 4 acres. Now, I believe during the 60 years, many attempts were made to remove those encroachments. One RDO who before me, when he went there, was actually pulled out of the vehicle and his clothes were torn and his vehicle was set on fire. So that was the kind of resistance the people had shown there. So being the first posting, it was quite difficult for me to actually understand how this had to be how I had to go about this. The only thing I thought was that these people are encroachers, fine, but they're human beings. So we need to treat them with that kind of dignity and give them some other space to live in. So for almost about 2 months, it took me a lot of patience, a lot of deliberations to sit with them, talk to them and find out what exactly they wanted. They wanted houses. They wanted, some of them were, they needed jobs. They needed livelihoods. So we mapped the whole thing and then put forth a plan of action before them and told them that you will be given these many houses. Then came some more demands that we could meet, like things like they wanted more houses for those members of those families who were adults or who were above 18 years. Mm-hmm. So that we couldn't do. So we had to tell them we couldn't do that. Certain other things which we could do, we told them we would. And even then, it wasn't kind of getting finalized. So I would go sit with them, have meals with them, talk to them. Sometimes there would be a bereavement. I would go and visit them. Sometimes there would be a wedding. I would go and participate in their weddings. So that's how, having lunch, dinner sometimes with them, I could establish a rapport with them. And believe me, in a matter of just 2 months, once I got their confidence, each one of them broke their own houses, retrieved whatever could be retrieved in terms of doors and windows kind of things, and left the place. That's it. And 4 acres in just one night was completely free of encroachments. And the then MLA of that area at that point of time was from the opposition. I don't want to name, and I don't want to name parties or people, but this person called me on the phone. He was known to be a very very vociferous person and somebody who would normally not let these kind of things happen in his constituency without his consent. So, and moreover, he was from the opposition. So he called me and said, Devasena Garu, I have seen and heard how you handle these people. They are people of my constituency. Since you have done it with a human humanness, and they have gone without any force, 60 years of this problem has been sorted out, and I have no desire to come there and make any scene whatsoever. I leave it entirely to you to handle the situation. I'm not going to, though I am under pressure by many others to come and make a scene there. So this happened solely and simply because we treated it that way, the power of doing the right thing. That's what I was trying to say. It was right on our part to give them a chance to express what they wanted. It was right on our part to tell them that that was not the place they were to be in, because it was a public space. They were definitely encroachments and needed to be removed from there. And more importantly, that the government works with people and not against people. This was a very important message that we could send across. And that's how I thought, that basic value which our former president Kalam Garu used to say about being human, being confident and positive, and knowing the power of doing the right thing. That was my first lesson in my career. And after that, I will probably delve into other issues because there are so many other speakers. But there were so many other lessons that I've learned, mostly based on values inculcated by my parents. And fortunately for me, I've never had to say my parents taught me the wrong thing. Each time, each day that passes in my career, I only go on to believe and understand that my parents in all their wisdom said all the right things, and they are demonstrated 100% in my life, in every situation that I am in, and which are not too different from what President Kalam used to say. So Raveena, I will stop here because I tend to get quite elaborate in my talk. I'll leave the floor for others to say what they have to say and pitch in some time whenever I need to.
Thank you so much, Devasena. In fact, I was making notes when you were talking. And if so early on in your career, you were able to understand the importance of doing the right thing, preserving the dignity of people and making a personal connect, which helped you achieve what was seemingly not doable, I wouldn't say impossible, in 60 years. And if something could be done in 20 years, you just know then the power of doing the right thing. And that's where I think the encouragement comes for every person to keep doing the right thing over and over again. So thank you for those invaluable lessons that you leave behind. Not just now, but I'm going to keep coming back to you even in future times when I visit villages in